Joy or happiness, success or failure, peace or dismay. The foundations of our life rest on the words we receive. A word of hope and guidance, translated from the Temple of Solomon in Brazil. You're listening to A Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo.
Univere Video is your platform for Christian content, and it gives you access to the church meetings of the Universal Church around the world, and they are in English. Even the meetings at the Temple of Solomon that provide live, simultaneous translations to English. All you have to do is sign up, and this is how. Visit www.univerevideo.com online or download the application on your mobile device and complete the simple registration form. Have your bank card ready and choose your terms of payment. And before you know it, you'll be up and running. Stay connected to the things of faith during the 21 days fast of Daniel.
Look at this field of wheat. It's certainly one of the most beautiful scenes we could ever imagine. But don't fool yourself. In among the wheat, tares are also growing. Can you tell them apart? To the naked eye, it's almost impossible, because as they grow, they are identical. This is why, in his parable, the Lord Jesus taught his disciples that only time would show the true identity of each one. Let both grow together until the harvest. And at the time of harvest, I will say to the reapers, first gather together the tares and bind them in bundles to burn them, but gather the wheat into my barn. That's when we see the difference. When wheat is ripe with fully formed grains, it bows down with the weight of its grains. But the tares, which are poisonous, produce no grain and do not bow down. Instead, they are clearly seen among the stalks of wheat because they stand up straight. This is the time of separation. The tares are pulled up and the wheat is gathered into the barn. When we look at a crowd of people in a church, everyone appears the same. They all pray, sing, raise their hands in worship, and even speak of the things of God. But only those who are born of the Spirit have fruits of righteousness and bow down, like the wheat, before the will of God. But Christian tares are proud and do not accept discipline. They do not bow down, but stand up straight because they like to appear holy while their inner selves are full of poison. It will always be this way. Wherever there is wheat, there will be tares, to confuse, to poison, and if possible, to even cause the wheat to be pulled up and thrown into the fire. Only time will reveal what is inside each one. When we go through battles and deserts, when we are shaken up and even crushed, we reveal who we are inside. If we are wheat, fruit appears and remains. But if we are tares, we will refuse to bow down.
I came as a fragile being. As one of you, I felt your distress and have taken it all upon me. Therefore, you don't have to suffer, because after bearing all of your pain, I declared, it is finished.
God bless all of you in an abundant manner. May he be glorified, sanctified in the lives of each of you. I would like that you'd follow from now onwards with me every single day. We are going to speak about the verses of the priestly prayer which the Lord Jesus said. In the priestly prayer, he prayed for himself and he prayed for his followers, his disciples, those who accepted him. And I would like to try to share to you what the Holy Spirit has revealed to us within this prayer. The prayer of John chapter 17. Please, after when you can, read John chapter 17. The prayer which Jesus said, and he did not say this for everyone. He did not say this for everyone, for all humanity. The prayer which the Lord Jesus said was just for those whom the Father had given. Pay close attention. Jesus prayed for himself and for those whom God the Father had given to him. You see this right in the beginning of the prayer when he says, Jesus spoke these words, lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. He was about to be arrested, condemned, and crucified. The hour has come. Glorify your Son, that your Son also may glorify you. This is glorious. Glorify your Son, that your Son also may glorify you. Which means Jesus asked the Father that he, Jesus, may be glorified, that this glory may be returned to the Father. Jesus was not seeking praise. He was seeking to serve the Father. He was seeking to give, to return to the Father that which he received. That's why he says, glorify your Son, that your Son also may glorify you. And this is the will of God for each of us. Did you know that, my friend? Did you know that the world seeks glory, the glory of this world? So when you see soccer players, when they score a goal, normally, they even reach the point of asking the applause of the crowd. They want the glory. Singers, musicians, the famous, people who are talented, want to be glorified. And want to be glorified by whom? By the world. Look at the difference. Isn't this wonderful? People want to be glorified, recognized by the world. But Jesus asked the Father, his recognition from the Father to him, Jesus, that he, Jesus, could recognize and acknowledge and exalt him, that he could glorify him for the glory which he had received from the Father. The intimacy, his unity with God was so big, so immense. It has been described as inexplicable. Only those who have the Holy Spirit can understand this. But that's what he wants to do to you. Perhaps, my friend, you want to be recognized by other people. And for not receiving the recognition from others, you become upset in life. Because the more you desire to be glorified, more, you become embarrassed or depressed or more frustrated because the world wants the glory. When a child graduates and becomes a doctor and has a PhD in this and that, they have an intellectual qualification which is admired. So these people, they work and they want the acknowledgement, the recognition of everyone who is going to see their development of their talents, their wisdom, and their knowledge. Everybody desires this. Everybody. It's that thing. You give something to someone and immediately you expect that someone to say, "Thank you very much." Is it not like that? This is an expression of gratitude, of recognition. But this is normal. This is part of the daily life of a human being. But behind all of this, there is a great desire to receive the glory of this world. So everybody seeks the glory of this world. But those who are children of God, born of God, those who was born, who are born of the water and the Spirit, they seek the glory from above. Jesus said, "I do not seek the glory which comes from below. My glory comes from above." So when you receive the Holy Spirit, and here is one of the reasons why, one of the big reasons why you should invest, firstly, mainly in receiving the Holy Spirit. When you receive the Holy Spirit, you are not depending on the glory of anyone. The Father Himself honors you. The Father Himself honors you. Remember what we've been saying these days, that those who are rejected, those who are excluded, those who were defecated into this world, they have no father, no mother, they know nothing, they know no one. As someone said in a testimony, he said, "I had sexual relations with various people. I don't know who made me pregnant. I don't know who is the father of my son." Meaning, how many people want recognition, that people come to recognize, come to admire them, come to find them as important, and etc. But he who receives the Holy Spirit is honored by the Father Himself. He's honored by the Father Himself. Through Jesus, we are honored by the Father. God spoke to Eli, "You honor your children more than I." Why do you honor your children more than I? Let me tell you something. Those who honor me will be honored. Jesus was honoring the Father. Those who honor me will be honored. But those who despise me will be lightly esteemed. They will be brushed aside. And that's what happened to the judge, the prophet Eli. And obviously, he lost his children. Today, for example, you're going to see in the soapy Reis, a very important episode. It's worthwhile for you to watch and see how God honors, as the case of Samuel, and how God dishonors. It wasn't the devil, it was God who dishonored the one who swore to forever be his priest. My friend, let us keep watch. Let us prioritize God's glory. Let us prioritize Him as the first in our lives. Jesus did this. Father, my Father, glorify your Son so that your Son may glorify you. And he continues by saying, as you have given him authority over all flesh, Jesus had authority over all flesh, that he should give eternal life to as many as you give him. To as many as you give him. For example, it was the Father who gave me to Jesus. The Father surrendered me to Jesus. The Father took me filthy, dirty, disgusting, filled with sin, and gave me to the Son. The Son cleansed me with His blood, purified me, and gave me the Holy Spirit. And because of this, we seek to honor Him above everything. Why? Because He has saved us. He has glorified us with the glory of salvation, with the Holy Spirit. Tomorrow, we're going to speak more about this. You're going to understand this prayer of the Lord Jesus, and I'm sure that your life will not be the same. So, you who want to receive the Holy Spirit, do not forget, invest. From now, 8 days, next week, Monday, we are going to be entering the fast of Daniel. In fact, from Sunday midnight, we're in the fast of Daniel, this coming Sunday. So, I would like to ask you to evaluate your life, because perhaps you did and participated of so many fasts of Daniel, and nothing happened. You did not receive the Holy Spirit. Why? Because you were not cleansed by the blood of Jesus, purified. Why? You did not stop doing the wrong things which you knew were wrong. You kept grudges. You kept resentments. You did not forgive. You had the spirit of revenge. How can you receive the Holy Spirit if you have the spirit of revenge? You can't. So, my friend, revenge belongs to God. Only He can have revenge. We just need to obey His word. So start to cleanse yourself. Leave those frenemies, the gossips, malice. Remove malice from within your heart, the bad eyes towards other people, towards no one, no one. My friend, if you want to receive the Holy Spirit, you need to invest, you need to sacrifice. Sacrifice your being, sacrifice your glory. Your glory needs to come from above, not from below. God bless you, and until tomorrow, and tomorrow we are going to continue this meditation of the scripture of John chapter 17, which was the priestly prayer of the Lord Jesus. And when you are with me, when we're together, please get your Bible for you to follow the scripture of what we're going to read and explain. All right? Until tomorrow, in the name of the Lord Jesus.
CKG Helpline Call Center is open 24 hours a day, every day of the week, all year round. If you need help due to a serious problem you may be going through, if you feel that you have nowhere to turn to and desperately need someone to lend a listening ear, then we can help you. It doesn't matter who you are or what you have done, your religion or race. Your call will be answered by someone who genuinely cares about you and have your best interests at heart. We also arrange home visits or the housebound and hospital visits for anyone in great need of kindly human contact. Whether it is simply information you want or desperately need someone to talk to, we're here for you.
throne.